45's base gets a lot of outsized media attention. Another feature on 45's inbred voters in their maggot hats talking about how they'll never abandon 45. But one thing that hasn't gotten due media treatment is 45's own view of his base. 45 has concluded variously that his base would salute his winking at white supremacists, that his base would rally to his corrupt pardoning of Joe Arpaio, a racist who cruelly abused immigrant inmates, and that his base would roll over forced separation of migrant families. He says he says the inbred people love it, he reportedly mused. Now we're learning that the 45 campaign wants to galvanize his base in part by continuing to urge the country to reopen faster. That's not surprising except for one thing. This will be happening even as the numbers of people getting infected with the novel coronavirus are spiking dangerously in numerous states that voted for him, something that will get worse in coming weeks. What exactly does this say about 45's view of his own inbred base voters? The Associated Press reports that 45's campaign advisors, recognizing that his position against Joe Biden is deteriorating, are sharpening his focus on his most ardent base of inbred supporters. Notably, these advisors describe a strategy that is unabashedly aimed at a minority of Americans and are not even bothering to try to broaden 45's appeal. The calculation is that around 40% support 45 and that few additional voters can be won over, leaving only one option. The squatters' campaign advisors believe it comes down to getting the bigger proportion of the smaller group of people who love 45, basically they don't love him anyway, they just think they do, to turn out than the larger group of voters who expressed tepid support for Biden. This has led the campaign to focus on pleas to please the base. The AP reports, including hyping his wall and promising Supreme Court nominees who will excite social conservatives beyond their wildest dreams. Technically, 45's wall hasn't been built anyway, even though he likes to think that it has, but it hasn't really. Most strikingly, the AP reports this also includes a focus on reopening the nation's economy over public dwelling on this pandemic. But this week's New York Times Siena College polls found that across swing states, 55% of the voters say that the federal government's priority should be to limit the coronavirus spread, even if it harms the economy, while only 35% say that the priority should be restarting, the economy. Here's a state-by-state breakdown of those findings. In Arizona, 54% of the voters say the priority should be limiting the virus's spread, versus only 36% who say it should be restarting the economy. In Florida, those numbers are 54% to 35. In Michigan, those numbers are 55% to 33. In North Carolina, the numbers are 54% to 37%. In Pennsylvania, the numbers are 59 to 32. And in Wisconsin, those numbers are 57 to 37. And so what's immediately striking here is how shriveled the intended audience for his strategy has truly become. Meanwhile, it's likely that this will only further alienate the voters 45 needs to win back, and if cases continue spiking, this dynamic could get much worse. This is driven home by an important new analyst by Ron Brownstein, which finds that the coronavirus spike ripping through the Sun Belt would likely exacerbate 45's political problems. As Brownstein reports, cases are soaring in Phoenix and its suburbs in Maricopa County, which will probably decide who wins Arizona and in Miami-Dade and Florida, and the coronavirus is hitting Atlanta and its suburbs even as Biden has made Georgia competitive. The broader story told by Brownstein is that the Sun Belt virus surge could accelerate a trend in which the region's growing, diversifying suburbs are shifting away from the GOP, forcing 45 to squeeze even more voters at a place that are shrinking or stagnant in population. As it is, Biden now leads in Arizona and Florida. If he wins only Arizona, that's insurance against losing Wisconsin, where Biden also leads. If he wins Florida, it's over. Yeah, Biden wins Florida, then it's over, yeah. Even now, the GOP governors in Florida and Arizona are suddenly scrambling to contain this new surge, having reopened rapidly, as 45 urged. Now imagine what happens if cases continue spiking, as health experts tell Brownstein they fully expect. What does 45, who is now fully committed to a base strategy of cheering on our rapid reopening, say then? And why does the 45 campaign simply assume his inbred base will continue to be excited by his calls for rapid reopening if cases are spiking in those states and more people are getting sick? The very presumption is to assume the worst of his inbred voters. Let's grant for the sake of argument that 45's calls for a rapid reopening are speaking to genuine populist anger among people who are suffering economically, and they want to get back to work, even if those who want a speedy reopening constitute a small minority. Even if so, remember that 45 advisors and Republicans are resisting another big economic rescue, in part because they worry that extending supplemental unemployment benefits could discourage people from returning to work, which is not the case. That's driven by ideology, but it's also about creating delusion that we're roaring back, a deception effort that's central to 45's reelection, and more financial assistance might disrupt that illusion. Never mind that if cases keep spiking, that will slow the economic recovery, meaning more people will badly need financial help. 45 is betting it all on his on the coronavirus denial, and his inbred voters are along for the ride. Can anyone point to any sense in which 45 is operating in their actual interest here? No, I can't.